Hey guys, it's good to see you. Welcome back to my channel. I got a lot of stuff I want to talk to you about. You ready to get into it? As you've read and seen on TV, a lot of people says that we're near the end of the world. And two things has to happen. Three things has to happen. One, the two witnesses. There has to be two witnesses that show up and are seen across the world, you know, proclaiming the gospel. Two, they have to rebuild the temple, which they've done started. They have the red heifer that they sacrifice. Every single hair has to be perfect on that and everything. And they've got it, and they've got it in hiding. So they're getting ready to do that. Now, the Antichrist has to make himself known. He has to go in the temple and declare himself God. Well, there's been people speculating on who they think the Messiah is. I mean, you know, the false one. Whatever happens, y'all can't follow that dude, okay? Because that dude leads you straight into hell. Anyway, these video clips I'm going to show you is people's opinion of who the Antichrist they think could be. So, I'm going to let you check these out. And I'll be back in a second, and we'll talk about it, okay?
A major event in history happened today, and I'm going to let you know what it is. So, in short, this place, Israel, signed a peace treaty with this place known as the UAE, the United Arab Emirates. Now, keep in mind that Israel and its surrounding neighbors have always been in conflict. Now, the Bible does talk about a man in the end times who will come and create peace with Israel and its neighbors. And this man will be the Antichrist. So many people are asking, is this the end of time? Is this a sign that the end is near? I don't know. I would be lying if I said I did know. So all I'm saying to do is be on the lookout and educate yourself. Let's go.
What does President Trump have in common with a man who could potentially be the Antichrist? It may be his daughter Ivanka. Why? Because she married Jared Kushner. So what is it about this low-key guy that makes me believe he might be the Antichrist? This guy's such a private guy, nobody knows much about him, at least for now, but this was a pretty good start. Well, first of all, he's a modern Orthodox Jew, and the Kushner family is really good friends with Prime Minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu. As Donald Trump's senior advisor, he has been tasked with bringing peace to the Middle East. So he's always chilling out with all the leaders in the Middle East. And we know that the Antichrist will bring a 7-year peace treaty between Israel and the Arab nations, which he will break halfway through when he's possessed by Satan at the abomination of desolation. But I believe that the key to this whole thing is Palestine.
So what's up, guys? If you guys don't know what's going on, we're living in biblical prophecy and it's unfolding right in front of us. The peace treaty with Israel was signed today, which is biblical, and we all know that we are entering the 7-year tribulations. So I am urging you guys, okay? Once this first treaty gets signed, the Antichrist is gonna come and reestablish this treaty and make it stronger, and then the beginning of the temple is gonna be built. Now in the Bible, what that means is the Antichrist is coming very, very soon within our lifetime, okay? So it's extremely important right now, if I urge you guys to do anything, it's to get a relationship with Jesus Christ, get as close as you can with him before the time is too late. The time draws near. God is coming, Jesus is coming, there's a spiritual awakening. Please establish that relationship with God before it's too late.
Here's why I think this guy right here, Emmanuel Marcon, is the Antichrist. The Bible says that the Antichrist will rise from absolutely nowhere. The Bible says in Daniel 8:9, out of one of them came another horn, which started small but grew in power to the south and to the east towards the beautiful land. Macron had no political or electoral experience until he was elected president of France in 2017. Even The Spectator calls him the man from nowhere.
Also, he and Jesus were both born on the winter solstice.
On top of that, Emmanuel's parents were atheists, but somehow still named him Emmanuel Jean Michel Frederick Macron, which means God with us, gift from God, who is like God, peaceful ruler of Prince of Peace. Macron, a written or printed mark. Macron is also a globalist who wants to bring a one-world government. The Economist even calls him Europe's savior.
The man they believe is the second coming of Jesus. Bill Weir journeyed there to meet him.
Throughout the Bible, prophets, angels, and Jesus himself all promised that the Son of God would return to create heaven on earth. And throughout the ages, billions of Christians have wondered, when? But what if the second coming is here, now? There are a number of would-be messiahs who claim exactly that, and few are more physically convincing than a former Russian traffic cop named Sergei Torup. In the woods of rural Siberia, he is known as Vissarion, the teacher, and around 5,000 disciples live around him, growing their own food and feasting on his every word.
My whole body was trembling.
Come greater than that of the Dajjal.
You know, Christians and Jews will be among the first to follow him. They'll actually, the Jews will be the first to follow him because they are waiting for their Messiah to come. They don't believe that Isa alayhi salam was it. And they don't want to accept Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. So they'll be the first to follow a Dajjal. They say he is the real Isa. As for the Christians, they believe in the coming of Isa alayhi salam. Because they've mixed up their scriptures, they will think that this is the man. And because he will say, I am Isa, they will ask for him, alayhi salam, they will ask for miracles, and he will do these miracles. Some of them won't be convinced. See, afterwards he'll say that I am God. Ana ilahukum. Non-Muslim people and the weak Muslims will follow him.
The Dajjal will shake Iman to its core. And subhanallah, before he comes, 3 years will happen like this. In the first year, Allah Rabbul Izzah will order the sky to hold back a third of its rain. So a third of the water of the rain will be held back. And the second year, two-thirds will be held back. And the third year, there will be no rain. So,
I don't know if y'all have heard of Dolores Cannon, but what she used to, which she's passed away now, but she would put people in this hypnotic state, I'm talking about globally, and take them to the deepest level possible, which would bring them back to their like past lives and stuff like that. Anyway, she talked to some of them that had said that they saw who the Antichrist is. While they was in that hypnotic state, she had an artist in there with them, and they was describing him, and the artist drew his photo. Now, how true that is, I mean, you know, as far as it being the Antichrist, I don't know, but I got a copy of that photo, and I'll attach it to this video so you can see it, and maybe you can see who you think he looks like. I think he looks like Ivanka Trump's husband. That's just who I think that picture favors. That don't mean that I'm saying he's Santa Claus, so y'all don't get me mistaken on that, okay? But anyway, either way, we just gotta make sure we're ready when it's time to go out of here. I'm telling you, think things has been bad now, they get even worse if you're left behind. Right? And the only way, too, I have figured out finally, if you can put all of your anger and your bitterness and all your past emotions behind you, you can have a happier life. You really can. I mean, somebody might have hurt you in your past, but if you keep hanging on to that anger, then they're still hurting you, are they not? The Bible says it's okay to get mad, but you can't stay mad. Right? That's the truth. It will kill you. Eventually, it can cause you to be sick, and I know that for a fact. I went through 7 years trying to overcome anger and bitterness. I felt like the whole world was laying on my shoulders, because I was just trying to take care of things that I can't handle alone sometimes. I mean, you know, we all go through that. The only thing we can do, people, is do what you can do. Do what's right in your heart and do the best you can do. So when you go to sleep at night, you know you've done your best. That's all you can do, and I think that's all God expects of us. Do what's right in your heart, no matter who it makes mad or whatever, right? Check this out.
Talking about the predictions with the popes, because he saw all of the popes, and he did see that in this time period would be the last of the popes, that there was going to be three, and the last one, when he was assassinated, that would be the downfall of the church. He called it the Pope of the Antichrist.
What? So
that's what I kept wondering. Some of these things have not come true. And I kept wondering, well, does this mean all of this is wrong?
No. Nope.
I don't believe so, because
it's not come true. That's this Pope right now.
Another thing, they had a peace deal agreement in Israel, which is what's leading people also to believe that we're at the end times, because the Antichrist is supposed to break that agreement in the middle of it. It's supposed to be like a 7-year peace deal, and he breaks it like 3.5 years or something like that. And the one that got all that together was Ivanka Trump's husband. Kushner's his name, I think. Anyway, there's so much stuff to all that. And I do think it's closer than we think it is. You know, and plus they're having all this alien talk and everything about where NASA's up there in space, all that stuff. Aliens and all that, that's going to be a big deception that will come through eventually. I hope y'all can hear me. The minute my butt hit this picnic table, across the fence, down the road, they decided they're going to run a big lawnmower, and it sounds like a tractor, so I hope y'all can hear me. They come over here to grapes, though, see? And this guy decided to ride a bicycle. It's really peaceful over here because there ain't nobody here usually. I come here sometimes just hang out, read books and stuff, you know. Sometimes you gotta get a break, take a break from everybody and just chill. Find your own space. That's what helped me a lot. Oh, another thing, I forgot to tell y'all. They had a boat parade for Trump. All these boats got together in the ocean and stuff, you know, I had the Trump flags and all that, and I got clips I'll show you, but it broke the world record of all them boats and stuff together. That's pretty cool, huh? And I'll share videos soon, so. I hope y'all's day's going good. If it ain't, need to do something about that, dude. Get outside and get some fresh air. Sitting in the house ain't gonna do you no good. You can do that in the wintertime. If nothing else, just go sit on a porch. Feel the wind, you know? I don't understand some people. I really don't. They just stay in the house all day long. I can't live like that, people. I have to get out and about, don't you? Anyway. There's a lot going on, but like where we was talking about Dolores Cannon earlier, whenever she would go through that, take them through that hypnotic state to the deepest level, this is different people across, you know, at different times across the planet. She'd travel, you know, and do that, and their voices would change. And some of them would speak in different languages and stuff because their past life or something, you know. But the thing is, the one that was giving her all this information, you know, about the Antichrist and things like that, it would be the same voice that was coming through those people. Different people now that didn't even know each other. It'd be the same voice come through talking to her. And so she wrote all this stuff down. She talks about this one woman. Now, I mean, I don't know how true all that stuff is, but she talked about this one woman that it took her all the way back to the time of Jesus. And she talked to Jesus about when he was on earth, you know, Jesus and the Essenes. You can check that out. Now, I'm not saying I agree with her 100% on things she says, but it's just something interesting, you know. I think it's good to venture out and find out things. A lot of people's like, I ain't listening to that. They ain't got nothing to do with religion. But you ain't gonna know nothing if you're just looking through the same window. You know what I'm saying? You're only gonna see what's through that window. Sometimes you gotta go look through a different window. Make your own mind up. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, don't be so close-minded. Because you might learn something, you know? And, there's a whole lot goes on this planet. A lot of people don't even know what's going on. And a lot of them don't even care. I'd rather know what's going on, you know, wouldn't you? Well, the lawnmower's getting louder. I'll be back in a minute.
Bible foretold that the temple of Jerusalem would fall 40 years after the Messiah's death. That happened in 70 AD. It foretold that many Israelite people would be scattered among the nations. That happened in the diaspora. It foretold that the nation of Israel would be revived right before the dawn of the third millennium since the resurrection. That happened in 1948. It foretold that in the last days, the majority of people would be godless. And as you can see, atheism is rising. It says that before Jesus returns, the entire world will know who he is. And even if you ask an atheist who is the Son of God, they can tell you his name. Bible prophecy shows that what the Bible says would happen, has happened, and is happening. And the Antichrist. Why will so many follow him? Well, we're going to talk about that. You're going to know that when the Antichrist is on the scene doing all these things, that, well, 3.5 years later, Christ is going to come to stop him. So eventually you will know the year. So, with that being said, we will see what happens these next 10 years. I mean, I know some of you have brought that up. I'm not really a date setter type of person, but I will say that the next 10 years are going to be very interesting. And, I'll just leave it at that. We've heard about Samson fighting lions. We've all heard these great Bible stories, right? But one thing that many of us have not heard about are the two witnesses. Why is that? You see, in the book of Revelation, chapter 11, it says that right before Jesus returns, God will give power to his two witnesses. And it describes this vision that God gives John about them. John writes about how one day these powerful witnesses will come. And they are not going to just preach the gospel. No, they will be given power that will give evidence to the world that Jesus is king and he's coming back. The book of Revelation says that these two great prophets or witnesses will have fire that comes from their mouth. There is one thing that happens before Christ returns. The resurrection. When Jesus returns, it says in 1 Thessalonians that the dead in Christ will rise first, and then it explains how we who are alive and remain will also be caught up into the air to meet him. And so you will know that it is Jesus who is here when all of his believers rise with immortal bodies. Okay, if you're here on earth and you don't have your immortal body and you have not risen, and there is some figure that seems to fit the description of the false Messiah, you will know it is not the true Messiah because the resurrection has not yet taken place. The dead in Christ will rise, and those alive to meet him in the air.
Agreed to by 179 nations. It's called the Agenda for the 21st Century. It's a totalitarian state being developed right now all over the world. It is the inventory and control plan. Inventory and control of all land, all water, all minerals, all plants, all animals, all construction, all means of production, all food, all energy, all information, and all human beings in the world. And this is a plan that was agreed to by 179 nations back in 1992. It's a United Nations plan. It's called the Agenda for the 21st Century. And so many of us around the world think that, sustainable development, it just sounds so great. It's a fact. The three pillars of United Nations Agenda 21 are economy, ecology, and equity, the three E's. And everyone sort of thinks that they know what that means, the idea of social equity. It must mean that, well, everyone's going to have access to clean water and clean air, and no one's property is going to be used as a dumping ground because they are at a poverty level. But really what social equity is about impoverishing huge portions of the population and bringing down the developed nations. Everything that we're looking at now is destined to collapse our economies. It's a totalitarian state being developed right now all over the world. And what major corporations want in this development is to be able to have full movement of workers, recycling and creative reuse, and creating energy and food resources for everyone. And the answer is no, it really is not. It's about moving populations into city centers, concentrated city centers, and clearing them out of the rural areas. All systems have to be brought into harmony in order to control them all. Because when systems don't meet, when they're out of balance or not in sync with one another, they can't be controlled centrally. And the goal of Agenda 21 is one world government and total control from a central unit. Every nation that signed on to Agenda 21 has its local Agenda 21 plan. People in the United States are completely unaware of this. If I go out and talk about this, the United States press will attack me and calls me.
Anyway, hey, I had to move locations because that guy decided that he was going to mow around where I was sitting. So anyway, as I got my car and was driving up here, there's a lot of people I saw that was mowing their yards and stuff like that, you know, working in a garden. Anyway, let me tell y'all something. If you mow your freaking yard, do not mow the grass clippings into the road. That's so redneck, man. Why do people do that? somebody evidently ain't taught them how to mow correctly or whatever, but stuff like that gets on my nerves. I know y'all laugh at me all you want, but does that not get on your nerves? It gets on my nerves. It takes away from the yard you're mowing. And everybody else has to drive through all that, them grass clippings. Anyway, people ride your butt too all the way up the road. Like I ain't got nothing else. They gotta get home because the freaking beans are burning. Or something. Anyway, I know, I get agitated. Just like everybody else, you know. Did you hear that bird? There's a lot of stuff goes on. A lot of people don't even notice. Some people would not even have noticed that bird with the big mouth back there. Anyway, I hope y'all doing good on this good Saturday, which is one of my favorite days, as I've said my whole life. There's a lot of stuff that's going on, like with NASA and stuff that we was talking about earlier, like with the aliens and all this stuff. They say there's proof of aliens. But, you know, I guess all them people that says they was abducted by aliens, I guess maybe they's telling the truth, I reckon. Who knows? Nothing surprises me anymore. What about y'all? Nothing. It's just crazy stuff goes on. You got all these devil worshippers and stuff going around. I don't think they really realize just how retarded that is, you know? And how can you not believe in God? I don't understand atheists. That's one thing I don't understand. I mean, you know, I'm just speaking things that goes through my mind here, people, but how can you not believe that there is a God with everything that's around you? Did you know that you yourself are a miracle? You are a miracle. Out of all them little sperm cells, you was the winner of that race. You already overcome a lot of obstacles just to get here. You ain't gonna give up now, are you? I'm not. No matter what happens in life, we can deal with it. We just have to keep going forward, people. And believe me, these days I just wanna get away from everybody. And sometimes you have to do that for your own sanity. You just have to take time to breathe and get away from everybody and just enjoy what's around you. A lot of people go through their life working, going home. Working at home, going to bed. Get up, go back to work. I mean, that's all their life consists of. You know? And that's sad, really, because you're missing everything in between. And that's just like where the kids have started back to school. I don't get to see my grandbabies that much now because they're in school. But that's not going to stop me. You hear me? I'm still going to see my babies. If I got to run them down. Anyway. Enjoy your day. Enjoy the rest of the video. And I'm going to get off here. I've got some things I got to get done at home. I got a couple loads of laundry I got to do. I got to mop my kitchen. And, a few other things. But enjoy your evening with your family. I know that seems mundane for me to keep saying that, but a lot of people take stuff for granted. When I was younger and my kids was at home, I was like, wow, I'll never get no time to myself, you know. Well, when they move out, the house gets quiet, too quiet. You'll go crazy if you don't find something to do. When you base your whole life around your children and all of a sudden your children grows up and has their own life, then what? Where's that leave you? Don't be so quick to put your life on the back burner. Don't do that, okay? Find your happy spot, your happy time, your happiness, and include your children in that. That's how you do that. Anyway, it's so hot, people, I'm telling you. I have got eat up by skaters where I was mowing and weed eating. I had on shorts and everybody's like, you need to wear blue jeans. But I will stroke out if I wear blue jeans trying to do that. It's so hot. So it's either get eat up by mosquitoes or roast to death. Picky torture. I've got eat up by skaters. It's just, and I even use that off stuff, which is bull crap. I think that just attracts them sometimes. But anyway, I love you guys. And don't forget to keep an eye on everything that's going on. And I expect that whenever they do have the election, there'll be a lot of stuff going on during all that. And I'll be glad when this election's over with. I'm tired of hearing about it, ain't you? But, I mean, you can't base your life on that kind of thing. But you do need to know what's going on. Keep your eyes open. Right? See, this is what's weird. I'm in this barn at Allendale, and it sounds just like it's raining. And it's not raining, people. You hear that? Does that not sound like rain to you? Now I'll walk out here and I'll show you. It's not raining. Not raining at all. Weird. So much weird crap on this planet. I know, I'm crazy. Anyway, have an awesome Saturday, people, okay? You know what I'm making for supper? Homemade potato soup and fried cornbread. Ain't that amazing? That's good. When it starts getting colder weather, my favorite thing to make is homemade chili. I usually make that, you know, when it starts getting cold. That's good eating, too. Anyway, if you ain't watched Dark, you need to watch Dark. That's pretty interesting. It gives you things to think about, which I've said that before, you know. And they got the season 5 of Lucifer is now on Netflix. Been waiting a while to watch that. That's something pretty interesting. And the Sweet Magnolias, that's pretty good. I usually, you know, my idea when I was younger on Saturday was go out and see what I can get into. Now, I look forward to making a good supper, take me a hot shower, put my pajamas on, curl up in the bed and watch Netflix movies till I go to sleep. That's what happens when you get older. Life slows way down, don't it? It's funny how things change, how as you get older, you see life differently. Yeah. Anyway, I love you guys, and I hope you have an awesome weekend. And I'll be back in a day or two with more updates of what's going down. But I'm going to add video clips to this, so you be sure you guys check it out. And remember, I love you, and Jesus loves you, and you're amazing. Don't believe anything else. Peace, baby. Did y'all know that show Supernatural? It's got about the Winchester brothers. It's got 15 seasons. It's on Netflix. If you've never seen that, you need to watch all 15 seasons. And trust me, it gets better the further you go. They're getting ready to do the very last season in October. And it's the last 7 episodes, and I'll probably have a meltdown. I love that show. I've been watching it for 15 seasons now. what, 15 years now. Long time. I started when it very first came out. And I've watched every single episode. And some of them I've watched three or four times. But if you all ain't seen that, check it out. Really. It does, it's like a story in a story. It's really good. I think it's good anyway. You know, it's like these two brothers go on like a ghost hunt, and then they fight demons and all this stuff, and angels show up, and even Lucifer shows up, and they battle him, you know. It's just something interesting to watch, but it is good TV. So, y'all pray I don't have a meltdown when it goes off. It's going to break my heart. I know, I have no life. Anyway, check us out.
A wise man once told me, and we don't end in blood.
I forgive you, Dean.
It doesn't start there either.
I think the mark is changing you.
Family cares about
you. We'll figure it out.
Not what you can do for them.
You always do.
Family's there.
Dean has given up.
You idiots have.
What's you?
Hell no. For the good.
For Dean.
Bad.
For Dean.
Oh, for Dean. They got your back.
Really?
Even when it hurts. That's family.
Save and close your eyes. Sometimes the bad's real bad. And the good, forgive me, it can come at one hell of a price.
The music of me killing me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
Hey! What am I supposed to do?
To try!
Cause you are the reason why I'm still.